Ladies Tour of Norway is the only world tour event for cycling in Norway, and it's a stage race, four stages this year. And we started in 2014, and we have stepped up the stairs step by stage yearly, and ended up with the World Tour status. We have a group of approximately 15 people, almost volunteers, working already from September, October with planning. But of course, we increased the level of planning, and a lot of consumption of the hours increase during the winter and of course the summertime. When you step up the organization before the last 2-3 weeks of the before the race started, we have totally 550 people working for Ladies Tour during the race week. The planning for the next year's race start already in September, October. And we start with an evaluation, what was good, what was not so good, what can we improve for next year's. And we listen to people, listen to media, listen to UCI, of course, listen to the riders, teams, and the communities, and all the sponsors, and try to improve every year. And it's a lot of planning, and we have to start very early, because we have to talk to the authorities, the local communities. We do a lot of inspections together with the authorities, together with the police, together with the community. And we start with the course. So we try to figure out all the courses before the end of January.
We have planned the parkour for the last half year, drawing it, talking to the police, talking to the National Road Agency to get allowance to all this. We have to put up the number of marshal we have to do and where we have to, for instance, move obstacles, where we have to poster obstacles. First of all, we talk about closing the roads. If it's any issues, if there is, for instance, we have a big hospital nearby, some of our courses. We don't want to interrupt for emergency units like a fire station or a hospital. So maybe we have to make a deviation or redesign the course because of that. And then we have to take notice for instance for railways, for bridges, for tunnels that we have a lot of in Norway. And then we have, of course, from the sporting view, it should be a challenging course. It should be an inspiring course for the riders to go. And also, we look a bit for the scenery, because it's sent live on national television and broadcasted worldwide. So we also want to show our beautiful country in the best way.
The start and finish arenas is of course the most difficult when it comes to planning. It's a lot of trucks, you know, and we look to see how we can promote the sponsors very well. And we have our design of the arena is already designed how to do it. So then we step up the last week before the race, and a lot of people are working more or less 24/7 to be ready. We have 5 years of experience, and we have a very continuous organization committee. It's more or less the same people which are responsible for the different positions in the organization. So I think it was more stressful the first 2 years, to be honest. But of course, it's a lot of work to do. But with experience and continuously working with the same people, we know how to handle it. We have a vision, mission and vision for Ladies Tour, that it has to be happiness. We have to do it with happiness. And if you can find the right people to create happiness together with of course, our colleagues, but also together with the communities and the sponsor, then it's more easy to attract people. Yeah. So that's important for us. Yeah.